गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर टू, अकाउंटिंग फॉर पार्टनरशिप फंडामेंटल्स, एंड वी आर डूइंग टॉपिक इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स. ओके, चैप्टर टू. Okay, interest on drawing, and we have already discussed simple method and product method, right? And today, and we have already discussed monthly drawings, interest on monthly drawings, in which we have discussed when drawings are made in the beginning of every month, then average period was. Average period was at the time of beginning of each month. When any partner withdraw drawings every month in the beginning of each month, okay, then 6.5 months. We have already discussed in previous lecture. First point. And second point, when drawings are made at the end of the, when drawings are made at the end of every month, then average period was 5.5 months. And third point was, when drawings are made at the mid of every month, and time period is, average period is 6 months. And now today we will discuss practically this point. Illustration, next illustration. A, B, and C. We have three partners, and you are informed that first point is A draws rupees 10,000 from firm. Okay, A withdraws rupees 10,000 from the firm in the beginning of every month. Solution. So students, when any partner withdraw same amount from the firm in the beginning of every month, then we will use average period is 6.5. You know the formula: time left after first drawing plus time left after last drawing divided by 2. Okay, you can calculate this thing. So I am using just 6.5 months, and I will calculate this amount. You will take 10,000 into 12. Check last line. Interest on drawing is to be charged at the rate 8% per annum. Calculate in withdraw 10,000 beginning, in the beginning of every month. So that's why we will. Or 6.5 you can use. Okay, now calculate this thing. Amount answer will be 5,200. That is the interest on drawing in first part. And second part, B withdraws rupees 10,000 from the firm at the end of every month. B D withdraw rupees 10,000 at end of every month, right? When any partner withdraw same amount at the end of every month, then we will use average spend of half. How? We will use same formula. Which formula? Now amount will be 10,000 into 12 is equal to 1,20,000. Okay. Now we will use formula. Interest is equal to 1,20,000. Rate of interest same 8/100 multiplied by. Now we will use 5.5 months or 11/2 as you wish. You can use 11/2. Okay. Now you can calculate this thing. Answer will be. In your notebook, C partner withdraw rupees 10,000 from the firm in the middle of every month. Middle means at any date, means not given any specific date. In between, when he want, but amount will be same amount he withdraw. Okay, in the middle. Of every month. Okay. Now amount again will be 10,000 multiplied by 12. We will calculate this amount for 12 months. 1,20,000. Now we will use formula to calculate interest is equal to 1,20,000 multiplied by same rate of interest 8% multiplied by 6 months. When any person withdraw at the mid of the every month, then average period time is 6 months. We will use 6/12. Okay, answer you can calculate. It will be 4,800. Right. Now we will discuss next topic. Next topic is when drawings of equal amount are made in beginning of each quarter. So student, the quarter. Next, second topic is the quarterly. When any partner withdraw any amount, same amount, but amount should be same, but he withdraw quarterly. Means when drawings, first point is when drawings of equal amount are made in the beginning. This is again second topic, quarterly, in which first heading, when drawings are made in the beginning of each quarter. Students, how many quarters in 1 year? in the beginning, it means first time he will withdraw. On 1st April, after 1st April, April, May, June, 1st July, then he will withdraw 1st July. Okay, after July, July, August, September, 1st October. Okay, 1st October, after 1st October, 1st January. This is the beginning of each quarter, right? First quarter will start from 1st April, second quarter will start from 1st July, second quarter will start from 1st October, and fourth quarter will start from 1st January, right? So these are the dates. So in the beginning, now we will use same formula, average period is equal to time left after first drawing. Plus time left after last drawing divided by 2. Okay. So we will count now. After 1st April, how many months will left? 12 months complete plus time left after last drawing. Last drawing was on 1st January. So count January, February, March. It will be 3 months. So 12 plus 3 divided by 2. 15 by 2. 7.5 or 7.5 months. Right? Now we will calculate interest on drawing for 7.5 months in case of time made in the beginning of each quarter. Okay, clear? Next, second case, when drawings are made in the end of each quarter. Okay. Second point. At the end of each quarter, again, we have 4 quarters. But now quarters will start from the end of the date of first quarter will first quarter April, May, June. 30th June. Second quarter, July, August, September, 30th September. That is the last date of each quarter. Okay. First quarter will end on 30th June and second quarter will end on 30th September, then October, November, December, 31st December, and last will be 31st March. Again, we will use same formula, right? So 0 month is left, okay, divided by 2. So 9 plus 0 kya hoga? 9. 9 by 2 means 4.5 or 4.5 months. Okay. Here. And third one is, have you noted?
Ma'am, aapke screen visible nahi hai.
Now, is it visible?
Blur dikh raha hai, ma'am.
This is a network issue. So anyways, I'm repeating again this one. When drawings are made in the end of each quarter, you can note down. We have 4 quarters. First is on 30th June, second is the 30th September, third is the 31st December, and last one is the 31st March. Okay. Now we will use that formula, average period, time left after first drawing and plus time left after last drawing divided by 2. Right? Time left after first drawing. First drawing ke baad kya ko? Yes, students, this is the average period, time left after first drawings and time life left after last drawings. So you can count after 30th June. It will 9 months, and after time left after last drawing, so 0 month is here. So 9 + 0 / 2. 9/2, you can calculate 4.5 months. Okay, next point is, when drawings are made the mid of each quarter. Mid. Again, four quarters, but dates will different. Okay, in mid, okay, any date, but see, I'm just taking example, like 15th May. Okay, 15th May is the mid of the first quarter. First quarter start from the April 1st to 30th June, and mid date will be 15th May. Okay, so first quarter ka jo mid hai wo 15th May hai. And after second quarter start from the 1st July. So July, August, September, 15th August. 15th August will be the mid date. And third quarter mein, October, November, December. Okay, October, November, December. So November 15th, November. Right? And in last quarter, January, February, March. So 15th Feb will be the mid date of the last quarter, 15th Feb. Okay, so in this case, formula same we are using. Average period is equal to time left after first drawings plus time left after last drawings divided by 2. So average period nikalenge, time left after first drawings. So students, after 15th May, you can count months. Completely 10 months. So 10.5 months are left. So 10.5 plus next is time left after last drawing. Last drawing is on 15th Feb. Last drawing aapki 15th Feb ko hai. Then count the months after 15th Feb. Half month 15th Feb to 28th Feb. Half month plus 1 month of March. It will be 1.5 months. So 1.5 plus 1.5, right? Divided by 2. So 10.5 plus 1.5 divided by 2. It will 12 divided by 2, 6 months. Answer is 6 months. Okay. So the interest on the whole amount of drawings will be charged for 6 months. Now we will discuss next illustration. In your books, calculate the interest on drawings of Mr. Navdeep at the rate 10% per annum for the year ended 31st March 2018 in each of the following alternative cases. First one is, if he withdrew rupees 20,000 in the beginning of each quarter. So students, first point, when any partner withdrew in the beginning of each quarter, so abhi we have calculated amount month was 7.5, hai na? So why same we will use? Illustration. First of all, we will calculate total drawings. In case of month, we usually multiply by 12. But now, this is the case of quarter. So we will multiply quarterly amount, like first person, if he withdrew rupees 20,000, we will multiply by 4. Because 4 quarters we have in a year. So we will multiply by 4 times. Amount will be 80,000 annually. Right. Now average period, first in first case. Again, you will use same method, same formula, and but I am using just month. I know this is a 7.5 months. अभी मैंने आपको calculate करके दिया ये 7.5 months. I am using just formula. Interest on drawings to amount is 80,000. Rate of interest given in your question 10% in first line. And time period is the 7.5 divided by 12. You can calculate interest. Answer will be 5,000. Right? And case B, if he withdrew rupees 20,000 at the end of each quarter, in case of second, when he withdrew at the end time, then kya aaya tha aapke kitne months the? Four and a half months. Okay. And we will calculate interest on drawings. Again, amount will be same 80,000 annual amount. Rate 10%, 10 by 100, and months 4.5 divided by 12. And amount will be answer. Kya hoga iska dekh lo? 3,000. And in case third case C part. If he withdrew rupees 20,000 during the middle of the each quarter, so we will use 6 months, okay, average time. Interest on drawings is equal to 80,000 multiplied by 10% and by 100 for 6 months, 6 by 12. Okay, answer is 4,000. Rupees 4,000, right? Next question, next illustration you can do by yourself. And next topic is a half yearly. Okay, next heading. Third heading, half yearly. When drawings of equal are made only during a period of 6 months, means any partner when withdraw only for 6 months, right? This is called half yearly. So in the if he withdraw in starting, agar usne starting ke 6 months ke liye nikala hai, that in the beginning of each month, okay? And if wo in mid ka nikalta hai, then it in the middle of each month. And जब वो लास्ट के 6 months में निकालता है, then at the end of each month, okay? So in case when अब देखो वो पूरे साल में complete year में सिर्फ only 6 months के लिए ही निकाल रहा है, when partner withdraw completely, यानी कि पूरे साल के लिए जब वो निकाल रहा था, तो we are using only for 6 months. जो first आपका जो first time मैंने आपको introduce कराया था interest on drawings से, तो I have told you, you will use only for 6 months. So, abhi wo half yearly hi nikal raha hai, 6 months ke liye nikal raha hai. So, we will use half to half. Matlab half ka bhi half ho jayega. That will be 3 months. Okay. So, it will be approximate 3. 3 say 3.5 or 2.5 or 3 like this. Okay. So, we will use again same formula. If he use the first 6 months. January, February, March, April, May, June. Okay, पहले 6 months में वो calculate कर रहे हैं. तो same formula we will use. Average period. Six months. Plus, you can half yearly in the beginning. Sorry, in the beginning of each month. So, in case second case is in the beginning, in the mid of each month, and third case. at the end of each month. So average period, note down the formula. Average period will be 6 months plus 1 month divided by 2. It will be 7/2, yani ki 3.5, ya 3.5 months. If we're in the mid, so again, it will be 5.5 months plus 0.5 months divided by 2, 3 months. Okay, half ka bhi half ho jayega, right? Or at the end of each month, 5 months plus 0 months divided by 2, 2.5 months. Right? So we will use next illustration, illustration number 25. P, Q and R are partners in a firm. You find that first one is P withdrew rupees 6,000 in the beginning of every month for 6 months ending 31st March 2018. So in this case, first of all, we have to calculate total drawings. So students, total drawings. P withdrew rupees 6,000 for 6 months. So we will multiply 6,000 into 6, right? 36,000 amount, total amount, and time period is every beginning of every month. So we will use average time period is 3.5 months. So we will use interest on drawings formula is equal to 36,000 multiplied by rate of interest is also given in last line, 8%, 8/100 for 3.5 months. So 3.5 divided by, okay. So यहाँ आप दस ये mind करना है कि 6 से multiply करना है आप, क्योंकि सिर्फ 6 months के लिए ही वो withdraw कर रहा है. Amount यहाँ 12 या 4 से नहीं होगा, 6 से होगा half yearly में. And now you can calculate the answer. Answer is 840 in first case. In second case, Q withdraw rupees 6,000 at the end of every month for 6 months ending 31st. Second case is mid. So we will use time period of 3 months. 3/12. Okay. Calculate these things. Answer is rupees 600. Okay. Third case, R withdrew rupees 6,000 in the middle of the every month for 6 months ending 31st March. This is the ending case. So amount will be same, 36,000. Interest on drawings is equal to 36,000 multiplied by 8/100 into 2.5 divided by 12. Okay, calculate these things. Answer will be 720. Right. So now you are able to calculate next 3 or 4 illustration and exercise questions. Right. I'm reading one question for you. Illustration, you please check from your books. It will be, I think, 30th or 31st. I'm reading, you just match it. The capital accounts of X and Y showed balances of 40,000 and rupees 20,000 on 1st April 2017. Mil gaya sabko ye question in your books? The capital account of X and Y showed balances of 40,000 and 20,000 on 1st April 2017. They shared profits in the ratio of 3:2. And they are allowed interest on capital at the rate 10% per annum and are charged interest on drawings at the rate 12% per annum. X also advanced a loan of 10,000 to the firm on 1st August 2017. All things you have already done, students, in previous questions. Okay? Nothing is new till now. Next paragraph. During the year, X withdrew rupees 1,000 per month in the beginning of every month. Now, this is a new topic we have already discussed today. So, this topic added. So, whereas Y withdrew rupees 1,000 per month at the end of every month. This topic ab aapka add hua hai. Otherwise, jo piche ka maine paragraph read kiya, wo sab aapka already you have done. Okay? Aur ye jo abhi humne topic discuss kiya, ye just act as a adjustment aapke paas question mein mil raha hai. So, during the year, X withdrew rupees 1,000 per month in the beginning. Ye person beginning mein withdraw कर रहा है and why withdraw rupees 1,000 per month at the end of every month. Okay, so you will calculate interest drawings in working note. Okay, working note में आपने इसको calculate करना है like this, जैसे भी हमने यहाँ पर calculate किया. So you can calculate interest on drawings amount and then you will put interest on drawings amount in profit and loss appropriation account, right? So the profits for the year ended 31st March 2018 before the above mentioned adjustments were rupees 20,960. This is the profit. Show the distribution of profits and prepare the partner's capital account. So students, first of all, you will make profit and loss account. Why? Because X loan is given in your question and rate of interest is not given. So automatically applied 6% per annum. Okay. You will calculate 6%. On 10,000 for how many months? You can count from 1st August to 31st March. 1st August से 31st March तक के months count कर लेना. और 10,000 पे आपने 6% per annum के accordingly interest on loan calculate करना है. That interest on loan we will charge from the profit and loss account, right? And after then, profit will transfer in profit and loss appropriation account. आपने इसको transfer कर देना है appropriation में. And appropriation account आपको सबको आता है. So interest on capital you will put and interest on drawing. Interest on drawing आपको इस method से करना है जो अभी अभी हमने आज किया है. वो monthly, quarterly या half yearly कुछ भी हो सकता है. Okay? Even 9 monthly भी हो सकता है. 9 monthly के केस में you will multiplied by 9 and वो भी मैं आपको clear कर देती हूँ. उसमें भी आप note कर लो. If time period is 9 monthly, just note down the average figure. When drawings note down answers. Okay. In second case, when drawings are made in the end of every month,